Okay, then let's have a look at this Hypercube model that I recently got, and I'm now going to dissect it. We are going to talk a little bit about these truncated pyramids or these fractals or fragments of one 4D Hypercube. So essentially we are more focusing on 4D Hypercube today in this little freestyle on this stuff. But anyway, so in one 4D Hypercube we have six of these fragments or fractals, which are each one realm, just like this reality-based system or duality-based system that we are now perceiving ourselves in still. And one of these is just like the flat earth, basically, because as you already learned, the flat earth is actually perpetuated within a truncated pyramid, yeah, a trapezoid-like realm, geometry-wise. And one of these flat earth realms or duality or reality based systems that are located within such a truncated pyramid here is only one fragment or one aspect of one 4D hypercube. So all these other trapezoids here are also most likely or almost definitely the same earth realm, basically, yeah. And these are like parallel versions thereof. And we are going to learn a little bit later when I put it together how this works and why it is very sensible or probable that these are actually really parallel Earth systems within one hypercube. But anyway, we're still here. So, let's do this here. I did this in the German version as well. So when we look at this here, this setup, we see a cross, right? So, as you already can conceive, what I'm going to tell you now is that basically the Roman Catholic Church, they co-opted this hypercube model, dissected when you put it, when you split it in these six fragments. So they based this cross on something very fundamental, but it's not what Christians, for instance, think as fundamental thereof. It's rather dealing with the general geometric setup of the whole earth, okay? So they co-opted this cross symbol for their agendas and religious mind control, but they derived it, actually, or distilled it from the actual environment wherein everything is transpiring, actually. So this is very funny. But anyway, so let's talk a little bit about this earth realm. Let's focus on one of these fractals here, on one realm. Yeah. So I have this laser pointer. Now let's talk a little bit about the rooftop, which is obviously flat, just as observed in reality. And as you also already know, the sun is moving from east to west. Let's conceive this as north, south, east, and west. And the sun is moving from east to west, dragged along by magnetic lines of force. Yeah. So, and we have this equator line, then we have the northern tropic, and we have the southern tropic. With the left hand, it's a little bit shaky, but I think it works. Anyway, so the sun is moving throughout the year, in quotation marks, from north to south. Yeah. So it's going from east to west, east to west, rinse and repeat, every day, day in, day out, always, okay? Because it's just the fucking magnetic model that is applied here, okay? So, anyway, the sun is moving from east to west, dragged along by magnetic lines and force, and we already got aware, or many are aware of reportings or sightings, that the sun has been observed north of the northern tropic. So, we wouldn't expect that. Normally, this should be impossible, actually, yeah? But it is frequently reported. So, how can this work? Well, actually, the sunlight itself is a reflection anyway, naturally, yeah? And we have these magnetic boundaries, yeah? These walls here, yeah? These magnetic walls. And the sunlight is actually also reflecting off of this, in this case, northern wall, okay? And therefore, people see the reflection that is coming off this northern magnetic wall, and then they see the sun. But it's a reflection, of this boundary, this northern boundary, because these walls or these confinements are of magnetic nature. These are magnetic walls, like reported on also in many ancient cosmologies, when they speak of mountains and stuff like that. These are these walls, magnetic walls or boundaries, confinements. And the sunlight is reflecting off of, for instance, of this rooftop, and thereby it becomes visible to us in the first place, because if light doesn't reflect off of something, you wouldn't be able to see it at all, because it's an instantaneous event. And so anyway, the light is reflecting off of these boundaries and the rooftop. Of course, it also reflects off the atmospheric density or layers, no question about that. But initially it becomes visible by reflecting off of this rooftop. And also when it reflects off of these boundaries, then maybe also in the south, maybe someone could observe that the sun is spotted more south than it should be residing or whatever. So okay, anyway, so this is magnetic models from east to west, because it's 4D structure, geometric support structure, wherein these realms are perpetuated, and all of these realms are single earth parallel systems. And I think I'm now going to put the hypercube together, because then I can go on with the stuff. And so give us a little break here. Okay, here we are again with the now complete hypercube. But before I forget that, let's talk a little bit about the diamond, because I totally missed this in the first video. So actually this diamond here, this is the absolutely the ground base of this realm. Yeah, it's a tilted square essentially, and the ground floor of a pyramid, because this whole thing is actually a pyramid, only it is capped at the top. So these realms, as we just have displayed. But anyway, so we have the diamond. And actually it's funny that this blue blue avians, but anyway. So the diamond's absolutely the model that you should look into when you want to make detail work. So go to Flat Earth Conspiracy Channel and Juan Valicky. They have this stuff completely figured out. So anyway, now we have this hypercube here. Yeah. Now the six fragments or fractals are combined or converged. And so, where's the laser pointer? So, let's talk a little bit about this red cube here in the middle, because this is where all the, basically the apexes of all these six fragments are converging and meeting again, if you like. And in the center thereof, there is the sun. That it's rotating due to toroidal acceleration, and it's doing its rotation, and thereby it's also instantaneously emitting its light, and this light is then reflected into all of these six fractals or fragments within this hypercube, into all these realms, like with from a prison, it's reflected into these realms here, yeah, and you can see this here with these nice effects with the laser. It's actually a little bit here refracting or whatever. But the light comes from within the black hole, and it's then reflected within into these fractals and these truncated pyramids or trapezoids. And when we go into this, black hole here, then we enter these dimensional realms or environments, like shown in Interstellar when he's entering the black hole. He's entering another dimensional setup, which is located in a different geometric support structure that is also perpetuated within toroid, because of course this 4D hypercube is also perpetuated within a toroid as always, and the toroid is within another support structure which is also perpetuated within a toroid, and so forth. But anyway, we are still with the 4D hypercube. So we have this black hole, the light is then reflected into all of these six fragments, and then it is there, with dragged along by magnetic lines of force, and they can observe the sunlight and anything else moving from east to west, whatever. Yeah. But when you are in this black hole, then you have the oversight over all of these fragments, all of these parallel reality-based systems or duality-based systems that are each located within such a fractal or fragment in one of these truncated pyramids in this case. Yeah. So you have the complete oversight over all of them, and this is also why it's so probable that these are all parallel systems of the same Earth. Because when you are in this black hole and you have this oversight over all these parallel existences and timelines, basically it's all about timelines again. Yeah, these are also timelines. Every one of these single dimensional cubes, or however we want to call them, where you can look into when you are in this state of consciousness, or on this frequency, or on this environment, in the end, ultimately in the environment, where you can observe all of these parallel systems. We also upload a video, this infinitesimalography video, there you can see this displayed thanks to the interstellar bonus material. This is very mind-blowing, but also very advanced stuff. But anyway, so you have all these parallel realms, yeah, which you can observe, and these are entailed within this black hole in this new setup. But anyway, let's do this here. So imagine you have this cube here, yeah, and actually there's no movement, okay? What is happening is that your consciousness, the only thing that is moving essentially is your consciousness, but this cube here, yeah? Imagine now that there's another cube here, another cube here, another one here, and so forth ad infinitum. So cube, 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 and everywhere cubes. Behind this cube there are cubes, and here aside of it there were cubes, adjacent cubes everywhere, yeah. Just imagine that there were cubes everywhere, yeah. So let's focus on this one here, because we are now going through these cubes, and this is your consciousness here. It is moving through all of these cubes, and every of this cube, like this one here, these infinite cubes that you are basically projecting, it's a projection, you are projecting your consciousness through all these cubes, and thereby the dreamed up movement takes place. It is basically like a film reel, yeah, when you have all these pictures on the film reel, and we are when you then project light onto this film, you end up on a projection screen with moving pictures. And this is basically the same principle of what is transpiring here, with when your consciousness is moving through all these cubes that are lined up or are adjoined side by side. These, all these 4D hypercubes are adjacent side by side, and you are moving through them, and every single cube is one single moment, now moment, okay? Because it's a hologram, it's holographic, and it's infinite holographic, and therefore it's no problem. They are also repeating within themselves, but this is then another dimensional setup, and this is a higher dimensional geometric support structure. So we stay with this here, and this is really, it's like a film. So again, it's like a film reel, and your consciousness is the light that is projected onto this film reel, and then all these holographic or super holographic environments and images and figures and everything comes to fruition. So your body and your environment is all holographic, super holographic, and it's consciousness moving endlessly through these cubes, these adjoined holographic super hologram cubes or super hologram cubes. Fuck shit. But anyway, so and within here, within this cube, there's a black hole, and these are the dielectric inertial plates. Yeah, and within them, the information is stored, and the light that is coming from within the black hole is projected through this dielectric inertial plate, and thereby the holograms or the holographic environment is created, or the holograms are created and generated. Yeah, and this is how everything comes to pass, which you are observing, which you are interacting with, and what have you. So you are living inside such a 4D hypercube, which itself is perpetuated within this octagonal hypercube, this prior Earth universe hologram construct. It's octagonal, and therein we have these 4D hypercubes, and they are the support structure for these 3D realms, the 3D truncated pyramid trapezoid like realms with a flat surface and a flat rooftop, and you have a certain angle which is also playing a role in the observation of the sky, the luminaries, and all this stuff. 23.5 or whatever. Go to the Flat Earth Conspiracy Channel, Juan Wallicki, they figured all this stuff out already. And yeah, so I think this is it. So this is where you live in here, in this cube, in one of these truncated pyramids here. It's flat, it's fucking flat. Yeah, and the rooftop is flat, and anything, and here's a black hole, and there was the sun and all this other stuff. But we are going to do more research on this, how this actually works, what rotation takes place therein, because what we see actually in the sky, like these plasma moon and sun and all the plasma luminaries, they're really looking like this, but their light comes from beyond the black hole, yeah, and it's hard to describe, but it's then channeled or converted into this realm, and then it's reflecting off of this, and then we can see it and record it and all this stuff. So anyway, this is it for this presentation. All unconditional love, all peace, all blessings.